Hey everybody, I'm Kyle Kruthofer here with the American Coaster Enthusiast, and here we have a longtime friend of Ace, Michael Graham of the Gravity Group. Mike, how are you doing this weekend?
I'm doing great. Yes, it's a beautiful day here in Florida, a lot better than Cincinnati. As I was leaving, the snowfall was coming down.
Yes, I probably left around the same time.
Pretty much.
So with this being IAAPA, exciting time. It's been about 2 years since the last one. What has kind of changed for you guys? What's new since the 2019 IAAPA?
So the 2019 IAAPA, we actually had a little bit bigger booth structure, same booth size. We reconfigured it a little bit from a size point of view. We have a Europe booth that's a little bit more portable. So we're like, you know, let's just do that, try to keep it a little bit simpler. We were over in Spain for the IAAPA Europe show recently, and we heard that a lot of people are going to be actually downsizing here. So if you look at some other manufacturers, they've got a lot of smaller spaces. There's empty spaces on the floor, even, you know, a couple booths over here. So I think the best thing about IAAPA this year is that it happened. It's happening. It happened. And we got to see a lot of the faces that we haven't seen for 2 years, and we got to present. We got to show off. This is the concept vehicle for a Tonnerre du Zeus.
Yes.
Over at Parc Asterix in France. So this is fun. Probably the main thing that's changed since 2019 is our engineered pre-cut track.
Yes, please elaborate on this. Now, you guys actually won a golden ticket award for this.
Yes, we did.
In the past couple months.
Yep.
Go into that a little bit. Congratulations, by the way.
Well, thank you.
That's a huge achievement.
It is. Yeah, we're stoked about it. We actually started development on this track probably over 5 years ago. We actually had a couple projects before Racer. Kentucky Flyer was a piece. We had a section on there. So you guys can all go look at that now. nobody just happened to notice. And so that was fine because we kind of wanted to get a little bit of time on it, kind of get past some of those initial butterflies, I guess you could say, from a design point of view. But really, actually, there wasn't many butterflies. It was rock solid from the get-go. So technically speaking, the wood coaster track is a cool track because it's made from pieces that you bend into shape, typically. So the problem there is that over time, you think of it as like a deck of cards.
Okay.
You know, a deck of cards can kind of do this, right? You do the bridge, you do the shuffle. Don't do it at the same time because then you don't know, I don't know, whatever.
Find out for yourself.
Yeah, exactly. So between supports, which we call ledges along the track, so the track's going like this, there's actually a little bit of movement that you see. You can actually observe this, you know, in real life. And the result of that is the feeling of sometimes in the valley, you feel a, and sometimes you feel, and then you're like, you know what? I think I actually felt airtime in that valley. That's not supposed to happen. Not supposed to. Yes, it's airtime. No, not supposed to happen. What we wanted to do is we wanted to come up with a solution that was number one, economical, number two, strong, and number three, precise. We felt that if all three of those could be had, we could have a real winner. And so, you know, our traditional track is made out of boards, you know, 2x10s, 2x12s, 2x14s, 2x8s. And so we wanted to say, okay, we're gonna start with this as a Lego piece. How can we put all these pieces together to, in whatever manufacturing process is available, to create something that was those hit those three goals. It was economical, it was strong, and it was precise. And so we actually looked in the Wayback Machine of wood coasters. So way in the way back, and perfect example, take a look at the Camden Park Big Dipper on-ride or off-ride photos if you have some. In the valleys, they have horizontal layers like this.
Okay.
Because you can bend them in that direction. It's not exactly a smooth shape. You know, there's a lot of visual changes that could happen if you ride that. But, you know, it's well padded. It's fine. One of the three rides that still has NEDs, by the way, or two really now. And then in the curves, they don't have horizontal layers that are cut. They're actually vertical layers that are bent. Mm-hmm. So in their goals, it was about how do we do this with the least amount of sawing, because they did not have power saws like we have. So that's cool. So they lowered these vertical boards. You'll see that on a lot of old coasters. However, a vertical board doesn't bend, which is a good and a bad thing. A vertical board doesn't bend, meaning, you know, you're going to support your train well.
Right.
A vertical board doesn't bend, meaning you can't put this in any type of up and down shape. And so we said, okay, let's cut that shape into the track. We know it's strong. And so we're going to cut that shape. We get the precision. So we're using a CNC machine. So computer numerically controlled is what CNC means. So we take our design data, we actually put that into a machine, we get a part out. So it's not like 3D printing a coaster, but it's a little bit like that. You know, CNC code is actually kind of similar. So so you take these chunks of wood that are pre-cut, and we put them together. And what we end up with is a track that is 30 times stronger than the traditional track. And what that does is when you feel it, you don't really feel that same, you know, particularly the negative style of that pulse. You just feel super smooth. Like when you ride racer, it's just like, this is amazing. Like, it's like you go up and you go down and you go up and again, and it's like, this is like really feels
good. It's like airtime.
Good.
I can personally say that I, growing up, Kings Island is my home park, and growing up, I always kind of overlooked racer until this year.
Absolutely.
Like, it's moved up a lot in my love for that park, and you guys have outdone yourselves. You've really revitalized an underappreciated coaster, I think.
Yeah.
And that's, congratulations.
Well, seriously. Thank you. That's I love riding with my family, and everyone's like, Daddy worked on this ride, and, you know, and we're like, this is the nuts and bolts of, like, we know the wood coaster, we know how to make this work. This is the track for this, you know, this application. And it's economical for the park. They were able to do it with their budget that they had. And the strength, you know, strength is cool, but what strength is there's a strong correlation between life and strength. So the life of the track, instead of a traditional track, you know, a traditional track might start out smooth. Like, you retrack a coaster, it's like, oh, great, everything's great. And then like two years later, it's like, okay, it's still good. I remember that retrack. And then 5 years later, it's like, what retrack? And so it's like, we got to have something that has that longer life. And the key to that is the increase of strength. And so we feel like, and what we've seen so far is that there's no change that we typically see with traditional track over time. There's literally no change in the feel. So that's fantastic. We see this as the future of wood coasters. The other thing that I forgot to mention is the other fourth goal is we wanted it authentic. We wanted it made out of wood.
Yeah.
There's plenty of other solutions out there that are not economical and not wood. And so we see that the future of wood coasters is wood. And we want to keep it that way.
Love it. Awesome. Like you mentioned earlier, Tonnerre de Zeus, we were actually sitting in the car right now, like you mentioned. Could you tell us a little more about that project? How's that coming along?
Yeah, so back in 97, Custom Coasters built Tonnerre de Zeus, which is Thunder of Zeus. In 2022, they're rebranding it Tonnerre du Zeus, which is two in French for those people who don't know the French part. So they like to kind of be clever with their words and stuff like that in that regard. So what we're doing is we're adding the Timberliner trains. It's a new control system. It's new braking. It's a, you know, really big upgrade to the ride. We started probably about 4 years ago doing a section of track each year, doing a retrack. So we're using, you know, our proprietary survey technique that we use to get the track just right. And so it's been running really impressively better and better and better. And then this year we're doing a whole bunch of changes on it with, you know, different areas being smoothed out and other changes that actually enhance the ride. So we're actually doing some reprofile rebanking. That should be really fun as well. So they're going to get these trains. Next spring, all those people in France and all those people who are going to visit France can experience the Tonnerre de Zeus.
Yes, and I believe there's one cool special feature on the trains. Isn't that correct, towards the back?
There is, but I don't know if it's been announced. Yeah, actually, it has been announced.
Okay.
Yeah, the back car is actually going to face...
Oh,
face backwards.
Yes.
So it's cool. Actually similar to what we did on Australia. So yes. Our SeaWorld Australia ride, there's one car that goes backwards.
Leviathan, right?
Yes, Leviathan, yep.
Awesome.
The other thing that we're using a lot of this year on Tonnerre du Zeus is the pre-cut track. So there's a bunch of sections of pre-cut track on there.
Awesome,
so,
love that.
So yeah, we're excited. It's our shop is really busy right now, cutting track, and we got our field crew, you know, doing lots of work. So it'll be a lot. The reworks are always a ton of work compared to new rides, but we like wood coasters and we want to really make every single one that we can special.
Awesome, and I know it's that's awesome that you know after the past 2 years we had that to hear that you guys are busy. That's awesome because I know we all had a tough past 2 years, so that's really glad to hear, and hopefully in the next couple of years we'll see a rebound. Hopefully that time to rebound is now. Thank you so much, Mike, for taking your time out of your week to talk with me. And is there anything else you'd like to say?
I don't think so. Go out and ride our rides. They're they're a lot of fun. We like them, but we also like to everybody experience them too. You know, countless of times, it's like, I don't know how many times, they're like, I didn't realize that ride was so good.
Gravity Group is like the manufacturer for me where like I can re-ride so many times without getting tired or like having to brace and like, you know, intent. Like it's just, it's re-rideable. And that's a really important thing in the industry. Right
Yeah.
So
I paid him to say that, just so you know.
No, seriously, Kentucky Flyer is a fantastic ride. Yeah. I can stay on that all day and not get tired of it.
Yeah, go to Kentucky. Kentucky Flyer is awesome.
Yes. Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Mike.
Absolutely. Appreciate it, Kyle.
Appreciate it.